Our topic for today is paths and circuits. And here there are a few definitions in the beginning. So in order to illustrate these definitions, I've just chose one graph. And then here are those definitions. What is a walk? Walk is a sequence of vertexes connected with the edges. So looks like this, so B0, and then edge E1, B1, E2, and then B2, E3, and so on. Last one is EN, EN. So each of these edges is connecting the vertices around it. And so what would be the example of a walk? You start with a vertex. Let's say the one that we have in the notes. You start at A, let's say. So walk B, right? So we start at A, we choose E5, one of the edges, doesn't matter. Then we arrive at C, obviously. And the next one we choose is E6. So it's just like a really walk from one vertex to another using the available edges. And then E goes to, from E, you use E2, you come back to A, doesn't matter. Then you go, and then we use E5 again, so we walk again on E5, which is okay. And then we are back at C, we use E6 again, and from E we use E3, and we end it. So the only, the any sequence of vertices and edges connecting them is a walk. But then it's a path if we cannot traverse the same edge twice. So if we want a path here, let the path be also from A, so we go, let me erase this right now. Erase and restore the edges. Here they are. So if we have something like this, then on a path, we go from A to E5 to C, then we go E6 to E, which is E6, and then E2 to A, and then from A, you use E1 to B. So here's a path. And then what if we want a simple path? Then we are not allowed to visit the same city twice. So simple path would be, for example, it says here, so we go red again, so B to E1, and then we use E5 gets us to C, E6 gets us to E, and E3 gets us to G. So this is a simple path that actually never traverses the same edge twice, and never visits the same vertex twice. And then each of them has the closed version. Closed version is when the beginning of the walk and the end of the walk is the same. So these are not closed. So there's also closed walk. I have to give an example of that. Closed path, we call a circuit. And then close simple path, going cycle. All right. So another definition: graph G. So two vertices V and W are connected if there exists a walk that starts with V and ends with the W. and then graph is connected. If each two vertices are connected. So these are just definitions. So for example, on that one, here is the graph, and this is B, CA, here is E, here are D and F, and here is a G. This is obviously not connected graph because there's no walk from this point to others. So for example, B and E are not, do not have edge connecting them, but there is a walk. It's actually a simple path, and so B and E are connected, then C and A are connected, and so on, but they are not connected with these two that are labeled B and F, and they are not connected with G. And then if the vertices are connected, that's fairly easy to show that that's a relation of equivalence. So generally we have equivalence classes. Here's one equivalence class, so all these guys are connected. There's always a way to go from one to another. Then these two are connected, and G is just its own component. So these are connected components, equivalence classes. Components. All right, so that's the terminology. And then we can easily conclude the following lemma. Conclude that the following lemma is true. What if G is connected? Then for every true vertices, there is a connected path. Connecting. And this one is very important, actually. We will use it a few times in our reasoning. If a V and W are connected, by a circuit. So if there's a circuit connecting the V and W, and one edge of the circuit removed, the W will still be connected.
Here is C
connected by a path. So why is that? So a lemma is proved. Here it is. I can erase this. I'll leave the statement and try to prove it about it. So what proof? So first part says, if G is connected, then every two vertices are connected by a path. Why is that? If we have a walk, V0, V1, V2, and so on, and here is Vn, which is W, and then what? So if we have a walk, then what is preventing us from having a path? What is preventing us is that we are traversing the same edge twice. So for example, if we have here the edge V1, V2, but then again, if we have the same edge on some other place, VI, VI plus 1, then then what can we do? We can just remove. So let's say what? One of them is V1. So let's say that this one's V1. Then what can we do? We can just cut off the whole piece. We cut the whole piece here. Then what's happening? We are not losing any connectedness. And because this part of the walk goes just from V1 to V1, and then we are still connecting V0, V1, and then we cut off this, connect with Vi+1, and that extra edge is removed. And cleaning all the repeating edges, this way we don't lose connectedness. And at the end, we move all the extra redundant appearances of edges, and that will make it still connected without redundant edges. And that's exactly what a path is. And then part two, what would that be if there is a cycle or circuit? If there is a circuit where we have that connects V and W, then what happens? Then basically, if we have a circuit, there are two paths connecting V and W. One is if we write them in order, like, you know, V0, V1, V2, that's a circle, Vn, which is the same as V0, and then our V and W show up here. Then what happens? They have two alternative ways. So here they are, and then if that edge that we remove is in the in this, so there are two parts. So these two separate the circuit into two pieces. So this one I will call from W to V, let's say. So this one is clockwise and the other one is counterclockwise. So if the cutoff edge is in the clockwise part, then we have counterclockwise exit strategy. And the other way around, if it's in the counterclockwise part, then we have this clockwise strategy, and they are still connected. So that's kind of quite obvious. All right, now we want to discuss two special types of graphs and paths, and those are Euler graphs and Hamiltonian graphs. So what would be the Euler graphs? So 7.2.1 Euler graphs. So definition. Euler circuit of a graph G is a circuit that contains each edge of G and there is a famous story about the initiation and about the history of this problem, and that is the famous problem of Königsberg bridges. So there was a river, it happened in Königsberg, then Germany, then Russia, Kaliningrad. So there are two regions in the river, two islands, and there are two sides of the river, so I call islands A and the D, and then the side of the river, I'll just make a point B. And then the architecture of town was designed in such a way that there were two, there were bridges here connecting one island, there was one single bridge connecting this island, and the famous local puzzle was to actually to walk over all the bridges, and oh, there's one more here. To walk over all the bridges in town, to traverse them, walking each of them only once. And then, while solving this problem, actually Euler came to the ideas that are considered to be the beginning of the graph theory. So generally, the difficulty of this problem is in the fact that this cannot be done. So there is no, so since then we call that Euler path or Euler circuit. So Euler circuit here would be a way to start anywhere one wants and then try kind of to walk here and then maybe here or there, whatever. And then if I walk here, then what can I do? Maybe if I go there, that will get me here, I can cover this, but this one will not cover. And people were trying different solutions, none of them worked, and actually what Euler did, he gave a kind of consistent explanation why this really cannot be true. So generally, I will just preview the theorem that we'll show in a minute. Actually, not only that there is no Euler circuit, there is not even Euler path. Euler path is the same thing, just it doesn't have to start and end at the same point. And the reason that Euler provided actually is the beginning of our next theorem. And here is what he did. He made a graph. So here is C, here is A, here is B, and here is E. And whenever we have a connection between two vertexes, then we can connect them with the edge. So between C and A, there are two bridges, so there are two edges, so it's a multiple graph. And then between A and B, there are two edges. And then between A and D are two edges. Also between C and D, there are two edges. And then between B and E, there are two edges. And the whole trick here is to just count the degrees. So D has degree 3, 1, 2, 3. B has degree 3. And C has degree 3. And A has degree 5. And then, what we'll see in a minute, that will be our theorem, actually, if you want to have Euler circuit. We must have, all the degrees must be even. And then, if you allow just Euler path, then that means at most two odd degree, at most two odd degree vertices. So if we have these two facts, as I said, I'll put them on the board as our theorem, then it's obvious that here, this graph G has four odd degree vertices. So it cannot have an Euler path. So that's actually a resolution of that famous problem. Of course, at that time they didn't have all that machinery developed. And that's basically what we'll do in the rest of this subsection. We want to see why is that true, and why is that not only, it's obvious that it's necessary condition, but it's maybe less obvious why it's sufficient. So that's where where we are heading now. So we're gonna put a few theorems on the board. Here on 7.2.2 says a connected graph will be at least two vertices.
Of course, that's not the restriction. We need a theorem for such a simple case. With at least two vertices.
Has an Euler circuit. If and only if every vertex of the graph has an even degree. See, if and only if, so we need to prove it in both directions. First one is fairly simple. Without laws of generality, assume that there are no loops. Why? Because we don't need loops, they are not helping us construct Euler path and what our circuit. And what else? Their degree is 2, if you remember that. That's the reason why in the definition we said that every loop counts as 2, so that their removal doesn't change the type of degree, even or odd. So then, without laws of generality, we can assume that there are no loops. So generally what? If this is like, assume that this is the Euler path. Why am I not? So here it is, and then, so here they are connected with some edges e1, e2, e3, en. So suppose that this is the Euler path in the order of traversing the edges. And then what happens? So each vertex will appear somewhere here once or a few times. So let's imagine that certain vertex appears here. And then it appears somewhere else, and it appears somewhere else again. So let's say that appears k times. And then what? Each time it appears, it's not connected to itself. It's connected to 2 other edges, and how is it connected? It's connected with the 2 other vertices, with 2 edges, one coming into it, one leaving. Then again, if a V5, if this is an appearance, then there is one edge coming in, one going out, coming in, going out. So each of the appearances is associated with 2 edges. So if it appears, the vertex appears. K times the degree of that vertex is 2k. For each appearance k, we have 2 edges, one coming in, one going out, and that's it. Why? So what about the other direction? That one's slightly more complicated. What? So if every vertex has, so now we assume each vertex has even degree. What do we do then? So here is the idea. We start from a vertex, V0. So let the listing of the vertexes be V0, V1, V2. This is not a path, this is just the listing. So there's a list, we put labels on them, and here's what we do. We start with one of the vertices, let's say equals V0. It's connected graph, so V0 is connected with someone. What do we do here with some edge E1? We cut this edge and we put it on the display. So there is an edge E1 somewhere connecting V0 and V1. So it's on the side in the storage. Then what happens? V1, having an odd degree, one of them was cut, must have an exit edge. So there must be a V2 here that is connected.
then we cut that one off and put it on a display. So here is E2. And this is E2. And we keep going. And at the end, what will happen? See, there are finitely many edges. At the end, we'll just, we cannot cut edges anymore. When will that happen? It must happen back at V. Why? Because everybody, whenever you cut something, because everybody has even edge, whenever you cut on the way in, you have an extra one left because of evenness to just exit. So you always have option to exit. So for all the others, except what? Except V0, that spent that one already in the beginning. So once you get there, then you can just finish the whole process. So, and then as I said, in the meanwhile, we just recorded all these edges and we have a little short cycle. But we are not done yet. Why? Because if all the edges were cut off, if there are no edges left, we are done really. Here is your Euler circuit. But what if there are some edges that were just unaffected? There is a certain part here that actually didn't participate in that. Although it is connected. But the way we were cutting, we came back on V, but there are some other edges. Then what do? We just say, all right, now consider the subgraph that is obtained after removing all these guys that we already removed. So this is the graph G prime. Then by induction or by analogy, we can say G prime, as being a smaller graph, G prime has an Euler circuit. I could have organized this differently and say, we'll argue by induction, assume that all the smaller graphs have an Euler circuit, then I would use inductive hypothesis. Or say, see, keep going and get smaller and smaller graphs. Anyway, so what happens? So G prime, my induction hypothesis, G prime has an Euler circuit. And then what happens? Let that Euler circuit look like this somehow. Then why the whole graph has an Euler circuit? So here's what we do. G prime, since the graph is connected, there must be one connection here. If I had green, I would use it here. There must be connection between this island and my first circuit. So there must be a connection. So then how do I make the circuit for the whole graph? I go like this. I go on my first patch. I go until I hit that one where actually connection with the G prime occurs. Then what would I do? I would traverse that blue one. And then when I come back to V2, I would just continue this, and this is an Euler circuit. So this one visits V2, so it's not simple circuit, but it is a circuit because it just never traverses the same edge twice. And actually, so here it is, you go this way. Way, and this is a circle. So that's the proof of the theorem. And then, there is a version of this theorem for Euler paths, and I'll just mention it with a few comments. Theorem 7.2.3. So,
7.2.3, it says a connected graph has an Euler path if and only if it has 0 or 2 vertices of homology. In the second case, the path start and end at the odd degree vertices. How do we prove this? So generally, again, from left to right, it is similar. Why? So if we have an Euler path, then what happens? The same reasoning as before, all the intermediate points, wherever V appears, V is not one of A and B's, then what happens? The same reasoning as before, it must have coming edge and coming edge and leaving edge. So all the intermediate, so intermediate vertices. What about A and B? Then A and B are the only ones allowing us to have odd degree. And then what? It cannot be that one of them has odd degree, because the total degree must be even. So either none of them has odd degree, or both of them have odd degree. And then we also conclude that if that happens, we must start and end at the odd degree vertices, because we just said all the intermediate ones must be even, so you cannot have those odd ones to be intermediate. So we must start at A and then end with B. And then what? What can we say? How do we prove this statement? Proof is fairly simple, because for these guys actually here that have we can do the following actually. So generally we work the same way as before. We start with A, we keep cutting the edges, and then what? The only way that we can stop is either that we finish at B, but then we are done, or we finish at A, and then we have a circuit, we cut those edges, we apply induction hypothesis for what's inside, and then we connect the edges. So prove back.